Hi, this is Ranjit from tech2bus.com, and in this video, we're going to complete this open build computer that we are building. In the earlier video, I showed you how to install the processor on the motherboard, and in this video, we're going to install the other components that are required. And the things that we require are SMPS, PSU, a storage device. For this test build, I'm going to use a Kingston SSD, that is SSD Now 200V+, but you can also use a normal hard drive. And I also have one SATA cable that we got from the motherboard. But if you have multiple storage devices, then you'll need multiple SATA cables. We need memory also. I have 2 sticks of RAM, 4GB each, for a total of 8. And later on, when the installation is done, you can install your favorite operating system also. So first, I'm going to install the on the motherboard. We'll just first connect the power. So let me just keep all these things to the side for now. And the first thing that we're going to connect is the main motherboard cable. That's the 24-pin. This is the big one in your SMPS. Let me show you that. This is the big one. And we need to connect this. And don't try to push it. If you're doing it correctly, it'll just go easily in. And we have to connect this one also. And this is done. Do remember, you do not need to force anything. You do not need to apply a lot of pressure for anything. And the next thing we need to do is connect this 12-volt ATX cables. And they will go, if you notice over here, let me zoom in, here on the motherboard. And that it goes in there. I guess I need to put the SMPS on this side. Yes. So these two things are done. Let me zoom out now. We have connected the main cable and the ATX power cable. And now what we need to do is connect the other peripherals that we have. For example, first I'll show you how to connect this SSD. And the first thing we do is take the SATA cable that we got. And first, you see this pin, just take this and gently push it in. And now we need to connect the SATA power cable. From your SMPS, select one of the free SATA power cable. It'll look something like this. And you gently again push it. That's what you have done. And now on the motherboard, as this is a SSD, let me zoom in. Let me show you the SATA ports on this motherboard. And this is the native Intel SATA 3 ports. And this SSD that I'm using is also supports SATA 3. To get the best advantage, I'm going to connect it here. And to do that, I just plug it in and it's done. It's so easy. Now we have connected our storage device. Likewise, if you have a DVD-ROM or let's say another hard drive, do the same procedure. And now we're going to install, let me show you, RAM. And these are the RAM sticks. And if you notice in the RAM sticks, we have this notch over here. And let me bring the motherboard also. And let me zoom in to it. We also have a notch over here on the motherboard, if you can see here, this one. And we need to align it. And as we're going to use 2 RAM sticks to take advantage of dual channel RAM, notice that the RAM bays are colored. As we have only 2 sticks, so what I'm going to do is install it on this blue bay. Or you can also do it on the black one. But for showing you this, I'm just going to use the blue bay now. And I align this, if you notice, this notch is aligning here, and I just place it like here. And this is DDR3 RAM, and by using both our hands, gently apply a little bit of pressure, and you'll hear this clicking noise. That means RAM sticks have been installed correctly. And I'll do the same for the other RAM stick also that we have. And that's how easy it is to install the RAM. Now we have installed our RAM. The power is also there.
and now we can just connect our monitor, because as this is LGA 1155 socket and we're using a Sandy Bridge chip that has integrated graphics, we actually do not need a dedicated graphic card.
This is completely optional, but if you are a gamer or you have some specialized application that can take advantage of external graphic card, that's also pretty easy to do the same. And I'm going to show you how to install a external graphic card. And this is our sample graphic card.
And this one requires external power. You need to check if your power supply has a port like this, and you just connect it here. And on this motherboard, you see multiple PCIe Express slots. The thing is that start with the top one, and to install the card, you gently just align it and just push it. That way you have installed now an external graphic card.
Now our open build is complete. Just connect the monitor, keyboard and a mouse. Now we're going to power up this build for the first time. I'm switching on the Antec SMPS now.
And we have power over here, it says. And the system is trying to power, and it powers on. CPU fan is running, as you can see. And do I get a display is the question.
Yes, I do get a display on the monitor. The build that we have made works perfectly. And the thing that I suggest is go into your BIOS setting and check if all the peripherals are showing correctly. Once you have confirmed that everything is showing correctly in the BIOS, you can install your favorite operating system. For this build, I have used an ASUS Z77 based motherboard, Intel G620 CPU, and an Antec 450 watt SMPS. And for SSD, I've used a Kingston SSD. I have done unboxing videos for all the components, so you can check them out for more info. I'll leave the links in the show notes below. I hope you found this video useful. That's it for now. This is Ranjit from tech2bus.com, and I hope to see you in my next video.